بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. Dear students, in some previous videos we learned about marfu'at al-asma. Some of them we have already heard and some are remaining. So let's see the remaining marfu'at al-asma. We have already learned al-mubtada. Mubtada is also will be also marfu always. For example, al-balad mujtahidun. So al-balad is mubtada here, and he will rafa on al-balad, the last letter or the last letter of al-balad, because he mubtada. Number two, khabar also will be a rafa. It's rule. For example, Al-Ustad Shafiqun here. Shafiqun is khabar of Al-Ustaz, which is Mubtada. So, because of being khabar, Shafiqun is given rafa. Number three, Ismu Kana Ma Khawatiha. You know, we have already learned Kana Ma Khawatiha in detail. So, Ismu Kana Wa Akhawatiha. Ismu Kana Wa Akhawatiha come before Mubtada and Khabar, and at that time, after adding Ismu Kana Wa Akhawatiha with Mubtada and Khabar, there will be two kind of changing. Number one, the name of Mubtada will be changed, will be called Ismu Kana, not Mubtada. Ismu Kana will be called. And second changing is that khabar will be given nasab. So ismu kana will be the same, it means ismu kana will be given rafa as it was, but khabar will be given nasab. So there are two changes. Number one, the name of mubtada will be changed, will be called ismu kana, and khabar will be given nasab, means zabar. For example, kana Muhammad shuja'an. Muhammad was brave. So here, because of kana, Muhammad will be called ismu kana and will be given rafa as it was given earlier. But shuja'an will be, which is khabar of kana, is given nasab because of being khabar of kana. So here we are talking about ismu kana. Ismu kana also will be a rubber food, will be given rubber. Number four, khabaru inna ma khabariha. About khabaru inna ma khabariha also we have culture in detail. So, inna ma khabariha also come before mubtada and khabar. And here also, the name of mubtada will be changed. At this time also, mubtada will be called ismu inna, and khabar will be called khabaru inna. In this situation, when ismu inna wa khabariha will be added with mubtada khabar, mubtada will be given nasab, it means zabar, will be mansoob, and khabar will be marfu. In kana wa khabariha, mubtada will be, ismu kana will be raf marfu, and khabaru kana will be mansoob. In inna wa khawatiha, ismu inna will be mansoob, and khabaru inna will be marfu. Opposite of inna kana wa khawatiha. Kana wa khawatiha, inna khawatiha will be opposite and given, in giving the vowels. There are. Number five, we have already learned about mubtada khabar, ismu kana wa khabariha, khabaru inna wa khabariha. But today, which we did not learn till now, are ma wala mushabahi lais. You know, laisa is also one of kana wa khabariha. Is also one of fi'l namr. Yes. And you know, Kana Vasatiha act that Kana Vasatiha gives Rafa to is and Nasa to its cover. Same. Ma wala mushaba bilais. Ma wala. When ma wala, ma and la will come before mubtada and khabar, at that time ma and la will act like laisa. For example, mal maidanu fasihan. The field is not wide. Lal khadimu na'iman. The servant is not sleeping. So, you know, we have already learned that ma comes before fi'l mazi and negate the qaf, and la comes before fi'l mudhari and negate the present tense fi'l mudhari. But when ma and la will come before jumla ismiya, nominal sentence, at that time ma and la will act like laisa, which is one of the ismokana. Ma wa la, ma and la will act is mentioned here. Ma mal maida, it means ma will give rafa to its is and will give nasab to its khabar. La also will give the same. The isma of la will be marfu and khabar of la will be mansub. So we are talking about ismo ma and ismo la. It means ismo la and ismo ma will be marfu. Number 6, la an-nafi'a lil jinsi. Sometimes la will be used as laisa. Sometimes la will be used for negation the gender of the noun, all kind, the class of the noun. For example, la ahada wasibun fi safi. No one is fair in the class. Here, la ahada. Ahada is the ism of la, and wasibun is the khabar of la. And la is used here for negation of all types of people. No one. If you want to negate the class of that noun, all types of, for example, if you also la ilaha, no God, there is no God, la ilaha. It means you are denying all kinds of God. If you want to deny, all kinds of thing of that class, all kinds of people of that gender, at that time you will use la and nafi'a lil jins. Okay? And will give nasab to its mubtada and will give khabar, will give rafa to its, sorry, will give nasab to its ism and will give rafa to its khabar. But one thing you should know, that the ism of la always will be mabni bar fatha. It means will not accept the neem, always will be given single zabar, single fatha. So la ahada rasibun fil maydan fi safi, no one is safe in the class. La rajula mawjudun fil bayti, no one is present in the house. Like that, la ghaiba, there is no doubt. La ghaiba fihi dhalika al kitabu la ghaiba fihi. Sometimes the ism of la is hidden, become hidden. At that time, you can suppose that the noun, the subject of the ism of la is hidden. For example, la ghayba fihi, dhalika al-kitabu la ghayba fihi. This book, this is the book in which there is no doubt. So, la ghayba mawjoodun fihi, there is no doubt exists in this book. For example, la ilaha, there is no God. There is no God. Mawjoodun, there is no khabar is exists there. But we will suppose that khabar is hidden here. So, and sometimes it's open for like this and the la'ahada rasul. So, the khabar of la an-nafi'a lil-jins will be given kafa and will be marfu as is mentioned here. La'ahada rasul is marfu, la'ajula mawjudun is also khabar of la an-nafi'a lil-jins, that's why it's marfu. Number 7 of marfu, marfu'at, is fa'il. You know very well that fa'il will be marfu. So, for example, qara'a hamidun al-qur'ana, qara is fa'il, hamidun is fa'il, and fa'il huwa. What is fa'il? The person who does action. That is is called fa'il. So qara'a hamidun al-qur'ana, qara'a hamid recited the Quran. So qara'a is fa'il, hamidun is fa'il, and qur'ana is maf'ul, and fa'il is given mafa because of being fa'il. So there is no confusion in it. Next, number 8, na'ibul fa'il. You know, when we use passive voice, at that time we do not use subject. We relate the action to object. Same. When we want to relate the action to object, we use فعل مجهول in Arabic. Inshallah, we will learn later about فعل معروف and فعل مجهول. But when we use object in the place of subject, at that time object will be given, will be treated same as subject. For example, قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فِي الصَّفِّ فِي الْحَفْلَةِ. The Quran is recited in the program. So here, subject is not mentioned because there is no need. Directly, we mention, we are talking about the object which is recited. So, object is used here in the place of subject. No one knows who recited. Just we know that Quran is recited. So, Al-Quran, which is object, is mentioned, is used in the place of subject. That's why subject, sorry, object is also will be given the i'rab of subject. For example, in first sentence, hamidun is subject. That's why is given rafa because of being subject, because of being fa'il. Here, Quran is object but is used in place of subject. That's why it will be given the same i'rab, which is rafa, because it's is used in the place of file, place of subject, and file will is given rafa. That's why na'ibul fa'il, which is used in the place of subject, will be also given rafa, and it is called na'ibul fa'il in Arabic grammar. So these are the marfu'atul asma. Hope you understood. If you have any query, you can write in comment section. Inshallah, I will try to solve all the doubts and queries. That's it for today. Inshallah, in next video. We will learn the next lesson. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.